Shalom, shalom. It's like a shalom. I want to give all praises to the Most High Yahweh, Bahashem Yahashah, Mashiach, Bahashem Kakadash. And I'm back today with another video. Now, what I'm going to be going into today is basically that curse of Deuteronomy 28:64, where it says, "And the Lord shall scatter thee among all people from one end of the earth even unto the other, and there thou shalt serve other gods, which neither you, thou, nor your fathers, thy fathers, have known, even of wood and stone." Now, that curse of Deuteronomy 28:64, it goes a lot deep, especially if you read this book. From Babylon to Timbuktu, you'll see how deep that curse really goes. Now, before I get into that book, I'm going to actually look at some notes I wrote down from that book. Okay, starting off at the top, the Prophet Muhammad. The Prophet Muhammad adopted many principles and laws from Jewish religion. Okay, and compounded it with Islam. Now, they did do that. The offspring of Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, which is true. Christianity, Jesus Christ. Islam, the cobblestone. As you can see, Deuteronomy 28:64, where it says you worship gods made of wood and stone, like the cobblestone. All right, let's go ahead on and get in this. Let's go ahead on and see what this is. Now, this is proof right here. Islam and Judaism. The Prophet Muhammad adopted many principles and laws from the Jewish religion. First of all, the basic monotheism, which is the belief of one God. The Jewish Hindu, you know, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, Lord is one." And see, that's the Muhammad slogan, what they say in Arabic right there, okay? "There's no God but Allah, and Muhammad is the prophet of Allah." No. Now, yeah. So as y'all can see right here, Muhammad adopted the details of the Jewish calendar, the Day of Atonement, the Sabbath, the Bible, narratives of Matthias, and many points of ritual law. Incidentally, the Jews pray the three times a day facing the city of Jerusalem, which is east, and the Muslims, you know, true believers, pray five times a day facing the city of Mecca. Trying his best, Muhammad sought to convert the Jews to his new religion, which was not availed. The Jews admit and resistance to change. The high esteem which the Prophet held for the Jews was transformed in enmity. Instead of allies, he looked upon them as competitors. Muhammad indeed needed the confirmation of influential Jews to validate his mission, as all upstarts needed backing for someone influential. Muhammad turned against the Jews and became their torment, which is true. Now, as y'all can see, right here is where it changed everything. The two daughters of Judaism. Okay, now here is what Christianity, that false religion, and Islam, another false religion. Christianity, God of wood. Islam, the cobblestone. Alright, wood and stone. The offspring of Judaism are Christianity and Islam. Now history was repeating itself. The prophets, the proponents of Christianity said to the Jews, "We accept your Bible, morals, and monotheism. Only receive from us Jesus Christ, the great prophet and the Messiah, whom all the prophets spoke in the scripture." Because the Jews refused, they were despised and hated. Muhammad tried to construct his religion as closely as he could after Jewish religion. He favored the Jews by accepting many of their laws and traditions. When the Jews refused to be converted, he commanded his followers to stop turning to the holy city of Jerusalem in prayer, but rather turn to the city of Mecca. He changed the Jews' Yom Kippur, Day of Atonement, or fast day, which he had accepted for the month of Ramadan. Muhammad changed the Jewish Sabbath from Saturday to Friday. We have another parallel in with Christianity. In the 4th century, the church changed the Sabbath day from, you know, the church changed the Sabbath day to Sunday and reorganized its calendar to make Easter separate of Passover. See that? Now y'all see about those holidays. Like Christianity, also Muhammad included in his new Bible, the Quran. Accusations concerning the Jews, and nevertheless, the Quran glorifies many biblical personalities. In order to win the pagans into the church, Christianity adopted many barbaric customs and traditions. Likewise, Muhammad, to gain the loyalty of the pagan Arabs, adopted many of their beloved customs. The Kaaba stone, an idol, was to receive high regard in the new religion. Also, the pagan temple at Mecca was to remain as a holy site. So, now y'all see how deep this curse of Deuteronomy chapter 28:64 really goes. That is how deep the curse goes. Okay? That is how deep the curse goes. Now, trying to find Jeremiah. Hold on, if I can find it. Okay. Jeremiah chapter 17 verse 4, and thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thine heritage that I gave thee, and will cause thee to serve thine enemies in the land which thou knowest not, for ye have kindled a fire in my anger which shall burn forever. So, by us discontinuing from our heritage, my fellow Hebrew Israelites out there watching this video, alright, my fellow ox watching this video, by us discontinuing from our heritage, is how that curse of Deuteronomy 28:64 of us serving gods made of wood and stone. That is how that came about. Once we discontinued from our heritage, they used those barbaric tactics, you know, to force Christianity on us on those slave plantations. Just like the same thing with Islam. They might have did it to us and got our people up in Islam. Okay? This book, again, is called From Babylon to Timbuktu. I suggest y'all read this book. Okay? I suggest y'all read this book. Alright? Read this book and compare it up with the Bible. Really, it is important. And that curse of Deuteronomy 64, it goes way deep. Like, this right here, what I gave y'all today is some real meat. I hope this video was edifying. And until the next video, Shalom.